Hello everyone, so today we will start the next module, that is electrical installation for the power circuits. Okay, so we are already completed the second module, domestic installations. So there we are discussed the what are the different types of wirings for the domestic purposes and what are the safety devices should be used in the domestic applications, and also we have discussed the electrical wiring for the domestic buildings. And now we are going to discuss the electrical installation for the power circuits. So let us discuss what you mean by power circuits. So power circuit means, so in your house we are using the heater coils, coolers, refrigerators, air conditioners and other similar type of loads. So these are also we can call as a power point. But actually what we are discussing in the third module is the power circuit for the motors, the power circuit for the generators and the power circuit for the machine tools. So we are discussing, and also in general we can say the power circuit for all the special purpose large loads. Special purpose large loads. So mainly we are focusing in this module power circuit for the motors, generators, machine tools and also large type of similar loads. So normally if you want to give the connection to the motor, so how the single diagram will be used. So normally before that, so power circuit means, I will give the general standard values for the power circuit. So if the total load in a sub circuit, so one sub circuit can withstand maximum load of 3000 watts in power circuits, or number of points is equal to 2. So this we can call as a for the a very important condition for the power circuit loads. So for normally we have discussed in the domestic wiring, that is for lighting load. For lighting load, so we are using one sub circuit. One sub circuit is equal to maximum of 800 watts, or number of points, if you want to go through the points wise, then maximum number of points will be 10. But in the power circuits, the maximum number of points is 2 in one sub circuit, and with respect to the wattage, it is 3000 watt. Okay, this is one of the important standard rule as per the electricity rules. And now let us discuss the what is the single line diagram for the power circuits. So first one is the switch. So this is the switch. After that, using the conduit pipe, we are using to connect this pipe to the starter, because in the motor we are using the starters. What is the main purpose of using starters means, so to limit the starting current to the machine. So the starters are very much essential, because the starting current is almost 3 to 5 times the high compared to the the switch is connected to the starter. So different types of starters to be used for the three phase induction machines. So that we'll discuss later what type of starters are used. And now from the starter to the machine is connected. So here I will draw the machine. So you can consider any one AC machine or DC machine. So this is the machine. With proper foundation we are going to install the machine. And now in the machine we are having the motor terminal box. Okay, let us assume that this is the motor terminal box. So switch to starter, starter to motor. So in the motor there is a motor terminal box, and now we are going to connect from starter to motor to this motor terminal box using the flexible conduit pipe. So this is a flexible conduit pipe which is used at the end of the connections. Using the flexible conduit pipe we are using to connect the starter to motor. So this is very important. So this is the flexible conduit. Flexible conduit means it is a, you can also call as FC. Okay, and now so earthing should be done to the machine for the safety purpose. So this is the earthing wire is carried out from the starter to motor. So this is the earth wire. So this is a simple structure of going to connect the switch to starter, starter to motor. In the motor, we have the motor terminal box, and through flexible conduit pipe, so we are going to connect the starter to motor, and earthing wire is also connected from the starter to the motor. Okay, let us discuss a single line diagram which shows a tapping of supply from the bus bar chamber to the individual machines. So example, if there are more than two machines are there, motors are connected in a particular circuit, then how the connection should be taken, how the tapping should be taken from the main bus bar chamber. So that is the single line diagram of the taking supply from the bus bar chamber for the individual machines. So first, what you have to do is, so you have to take the supply from the main distribution board. So this is the, because in the three phase machines, three phases will be there, R, Y, B. So this is R, Y, B, and this will be taken from the main distribution board. So I have written DB. DB means is a distribution board. So from the main distribution board, so if you take the connection, so that will be connected to the main switch. Okay, so this is the main switch, and in the main switch box we are using the each one fuse for the safety purpose for each phase, and each phase one fuse is connected here. So that's why this is also called as main fuse switch box, because it contains the switch. Okay, triple pole, triple clad Allen switches are used here, and this is the individual fuse for each phase. So main distribution board to main switch board, and main switch board to, so we are going to use a bus bar chamber. So first I will draw the bus bar chamber here. Okay, so in the bus bar chamber, this is the bus bar chamber. So we are having the three lines, that is R, second line is Y, and third is B. So indicate this is R, Y, and B. So from this, so let's give the connection from R to, this is the R line, R to R, we need to give the tappings. Y to Y, tapping should be made, and B to B. So this is a connection, tapping the connection from the main distribution board to main switch board, and main switch board to the bus bar chamber. And now we are going to give from the bus bar chamber, we are tapping the connection to the individual machines. So let us discuss how the tappings will be taken from this bus bar chamber to the individual machines. So let us take, so tap the one phase for each machines from Y, from B, and from R. So tappings will be taken, and here we will connect the one switches, TPST switch, and from this, so individual fuse is connected. Okay, and this is the hole we can call as a fuse with switches for individual motor circuit. Okay, and now, so tappings will be taken from the each fuse. This will be connected to the motor starter, as we have discussed in the previous page, that is the connection from the switch to starter and starter to motor using the flexible conduit. So now from this starter we have got three phases, and the tappings will be made and giving to the motor one. Let us take, this is a motor one. Similarly, if you want to give the connection to the more number of motors from the same bus bar chamber, then you can use the one more tappings. So from each phase, from B, from Y, and from R, again use the TPST switch, and next use the fuse, individual fuse for the safety purpose, and this is the hole in it we can call as fuse switches, fuse switches for individual circuit, individual motor circuit. So this is how we can give the connection from the main distribution board to switchboard, switchboard to the bus bar chamber to the individual motor switch, starter and motor. This is a simple single diagram for the giving connections from the bus bar chamber to each motor. So this is the starter. And again we can take the same three outputs from the starter and give connection to the second motor. Let us take this is a motor 2. So this is the connection diagram for the tapping of supply from the main supply, main distribution board to switchboard, switchboard to the bus bar chamber to individual motor switch, starter and motor. So this is the connection diagram for the giving the connection to the three phase machines. That may be motors, that may be generators or any type of larger type of loads. Okay. So in the next video, we will discuss the what are the important considerations required for the motor installation. So that we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.